I know that gentleman.
Who?
The Viscount.
Apologies, sir. I did not mean to cause anyone concern.
Did your maid know you were riding astride?
I have no maid.
Ah, then you're married. Cavalier, but if I must leg shackle myself in marriage, the lady in question should have more to recommend her.
Do not tell us you were hoping for a love match.
Love is the last thing I desire. But if my children are to be of good stock, then their mother must be of impeccable quality. A pleasing face, an acceptable wit, genteel manners enough to credit a Viscountess. It should not be so hard to find. You.
Pardon me, my lord.
I never got your name. I was wondering if we'd meet again.
So you might discern if my wit is acceptable, my manners genteel.
But you were eavesdropping.
It was hardly an effort, seeing as you were proclaiming your many requirements for a wife loud enough for the entire party to hear.
You take issue with my requirements?
I take issue with any man who views women merely as chattels and breeding stock.
None of that was meant for
Viscount Bridgerton, yes? When you manage to find this paragon of virtue, whatever makes you think she will accept your suit? Are the young ladies of London truly so easily won by a pleasing smile and absolutely nothing more?
So you find my smile pleasing?
I find your opinion of yourself entirely too high. Your character is as deficient as your horsemanship. I shall bid you good night. How much clearer must I be?
I bought a gift for Miss Edwina.
Take your Trojan horse elsewhere.
I assure you, Miss Sharma, this is a very real horse. I'd not recommend trying to climb inside.
I have never met a man as brazenly presumptuous.
You do not even know me.
I know you are polished. I know you are careful. I know you make promises without so much as uttering a word. There is not much more I need to know.
I see my plan to win you over is already working.
I was smiling at the view, which you are now blocking.
Well, you brought your dog.
Yes. Newton is an excellent judge of character. Oh, see?
Mark my words, Miss Sharma. By the end of your stay, your opinion of me will be much improved.
Is this yours?
All right.
Are you the superstitious sort? I know some men cannot perform without their familiar tools. Like a child with a blanket. Are you in a losing mood?
My mood shall remain unchanged.
Your play, my lord. Unless you do not wish to dirty those fine boots.
Do not worry about my boots. Just pull.
I am trying. It is stuck.
Oh. Do you want my help or not? It is not amusing.
I did not say it was.
Tell me frankly, what must I do to win your approval?
I do not withhold it out of spite, my lord. I simply wish to steer my sister to the greatest possible happiness. I would have thought you could understand my position, seeing as you too have sisters to protect.
That is different. It is my duty as their guardian.
I am the same for Edwina in every way that matters.
Then let us put our past acrimony behind us. And allow me to prove I can offer your sister all the happiness and security you seek. Could you... Michelle.
No, no. I can assure you, happiness is not your strength. Exasperation, perhaps, vexation, most definitely. The only feeling you are in fact capable of engendering, my lord, is that of discontent.
Not...
Do not tell me
stand still,
what
dammit.
To do.
You're still convinced we have lost our prey?
I'm convinced that deer prefer the edge of the forest. This is much too open out here.
Yes, well, perhaps you're right. We should carry on.
Perhaps if you'd not been out once again the other morning, we might not have been put in such a difficult situation.
Exactly which difficult situation are you referring to, my lord?
Your... The other morning.
When I was stung.
After which you put my hand to your bosom.
To show you I was unharmed, you were overcome.
Indeed I was not.
You were the one who then looked at me.
You looked at me?
Not in the way that you did.
How exactly did I look?
Truly, brother, is there really no one you share similarities with? No one at all?
Do you have something you wish to ask me, my lord, regarding my sister?
If I were to ask your hand, would you give me your permission?
I want my sister to be happy.
And do you think I can make her happy?
That is a better question for you. Can you make her happy? If your silence is an indication you are reconsidering your declaration,
is that what you want? You need to reconsider.
It is not utter what I want.
I do not think that is true.
I am to return to India. The moment my sister marries, she will be married. She will not need me. There will be no more reason for me to stay.
Why are you so distressed?
When will you leave? Immediately. Once your sister is married?
I presume so, yes.
And you will not concern yourself with finding a match of your own?
Why would that concern you?
It seems to me you will find any excuse you can to keep me away from your sister. You simply do not like me.
Of course I do not like
you. Then tell me why. Have I done something to you? Why is it that you dislike me so?
Because you vex me.
And what is it do you think you do to me? You hate me.
Yes, I do. I hate you.
I am a gentleman.
And your heart is with my sister.
And my heart is with your sister. Say you do not care for me. Tell me you feel nothing, and I will walk away. Miss Edwina Sharma, will you marry me?
There is nothing appropriate about what you are doing proceeding with this engagement.
On the contrary, I believe it is the most proper outcome for all.
Oh, and what of everything that's passed between us at Aubrey Hall?
Nothing passed between us. I'm a gentleman.
Is that so? Need I remind you, sir, if anyone other than your sister discovered us in the library that night, then we too would be obliged to wed.
Nothing happened in that library.
What a handsome couple they make.
Miss Sharma.
Lord Bridgerton. I do not understand. Why are you suggesting this? All along, you have been set on marrying my sister despite my every objection, might I add, and now you intend to cast her aside. What has she done?
She has done nothing, it is you. You have made this match impossible.
But I am leaving for India.
And it is not far enough. Do you think that there is a corner of this earth that you could travel to far away enough to free me from this torment? I am a gentleman. My father raised me to act with honor, but that honor is hanging by a thread that grows more precarious with every moment I spend in your presence. You are the bane of my existence, the object of all my desires. Night and day, I dream of you. If I were your sister, it would bind me and you together for eternity, and I will spend every day of my marriage haunting you, dreaming of you, dreading the day when my last thread of honor finally snaps. Is that the future that you want for us? For your sister? I will talk with Miss Edwina today and see my way to ending things. It is the only way to ensure that the two of us can be rid of this impossible situation. Once the engagement is over, our paths need never cross again. It will be as if we had never met.
Please, Lord Bridgerton. Anthony, you must keep your word. You must marry my sister. You must marry her as soon as you can, because this feeling that plagues us so, it will pass. It will become tenable, it will become bearable, and soon enough it will be as if we never felt it at all. Mere passion. It must, because it has to.
Very well. I shall see that the wedding shall take place as soon as possible.
Anthony Bridgerton.
Do you love him?
We must speak.
Do you realize how improper this
is? I have just met with Miss Edwina.
I have ruined her life.
Just wait.
Why, my lord?
She had the courage to act on what she sensed between us, and here we are, standing perfectly still, having felt it for months.
I stand here because the moment we go, the moment we step foot outside those doors, we face the truth
of our situation.
Of our failures.
Miss Sharma, I've been wishing for a moment to be alone with you.
There's nothing to speak about, my lord.
We kissed.
We did not. Nothing happened between us. How could it? You were my sister's intended. There is no world in which we could kiss.
You have been like this from the moment I first met in those woods. Obstinate, inflexible, unyielding to good, plain, common sense.
Well, I can certainly understand why that would be so troubling for a man like you. A man used to always getting his way. A man used to giving orders without any...
Orders.
You give me orders and you expect me to listen. I do not listen.
Well, perhaps you should.
Oh, I shall never listen to you or to anyone I wholeheartedly disagree with.
Yeah.
The fact it has taken you this long to come to terms with that, to accept that fact...
You wish to know why?
I am uncertain you even know why.
I know why.
Oh, here we go. Enthrall me with your self-knowledge and awareness.
It is because I've never met anyone like you. It is maddening. How much you consume my very being. All I find myself being able to breathe for is you.
Please!
Stay with me. Come on now. Come on now. Call the surgeon at once!
It's me.
A blanket. She's still shivering.
Allow me to get to work.
It is all my fault.
Anthony.
She's awake.
Mrs. Wilson heard from one of the maids.
I do not think that I can see her.
Do not lose her, Anthony. You cannot lose her.
I called on you. The morning after. I called on you to apologize. You deserved so much more than that. I did not want it to happen like that. So, I came to apologize.
Yes, you already said that.
And to ask you to marry me.
My lord, I do not need you to ask me anything at all.
Kate.
I am returning to India. The moment I resolve matters with my sister, I am returning to India. It is decided.
You are running away.
Please go. Lord Bridgerton.
Misham, we should continue to keep our distance between us in light of the...
Perhaps we should not. Are you going to ask me to dance? One last time.
Are you going to say yes? Are you still planning to leave for India?
I have my sister's blessing, as well as my mother's. And the Queen herself has apparently saved our families from utter ruin.
I was fearful of losing you. It is why I could not visit you after your accident. I could not bring myself to it. I love you. I have loved you from the moment we raced each other in that park. I have loved you at every dance, on every walk, every time we've been together and every time we've been apart. You don't have to accept it, you don't have to embrace it, or even allow it, knowing you probably will not, but you must know it. In your heart. You must feel it, because I do.
I do not know what to say.
You do not have to say anything.
I do not think there is anything else to say. Other than I love you too.
I want a life that suits us both. I know I am imperfect, but I will humble myself before you, because I cannot imagine my life without you, and that is why I wish to marry you.
But you know there'll never be a day where you do not vex me.
Is that a promise, Kathanisham?
Yes. Yes, it is a promise.
Mama, it seems the two of us are finally seeing eye to eye on something.
I suppose we are.
I suppose that means they are cutting out.
No, we're not cutting out.
It's opportunity to return upstairs.
Then admit defeat. Never.